used to be that turbochargers were only found on diesel or some performance applications, but those days are quickly changing as more and more OEMs rely on turbocharged power plants to help them meet federal fuel economy and emissions standards. Now, these turbochargers are designed to last the life of the vehicle, but there are a number of reasons that a turbocharger can fail prematurely. Today, I want to share some of the more common causes of premature failure with you so that you can learn to identify and correct them so your customer's turbo will lead a long and healthy life. All that and more on today's edition of The Trainer. According to industry sources, nearly half of the vehicles being built by the OEMs today are equipped with turbochargers, and for good reason. It allows the engineers to literally boost the volumetric efficiency of these power plants by forcing more air than would otherwise get into the combustion chambers under normal aspiration. Now, more air means more fuel, and that means more power from any given engine displacement. That allows the engineers to also downsize the size of the engine, and that reduces weight, and that of course impacts fuel economy. The turbocharger itself is a high performance part manufactured to strict tolerances. It has to be, because turbos can spin at speeds approaching 300,000 RPM. And are exposed to some of the harshest conditions present under the hood, like exhaust gas temperatures in excess of 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. Understanding the causes of premature failure is important for a few reasons. Number one, if you're replacing a turbocharger that has failed, it's important to understand what caused the failure so you can correct it at the time of replacement. Additionally, if you see something on your customer's vehicle that you know could lead to the failure of the turbocharger, you may be able to identify and correct it before that damage occurs. A leading cause of premature failure is inadequate lubrication. The turbo, specifically the impeller shaft and support bearings and bushings, must be continuously fed a clean supply of oil to survive the demands placed on them. Be sure to show your customer how to check and maintain their own oil and express to them how important it is to check it every time they fill up their vehicle. Also explain that some oil usage between oil changes is normal and that they need to keep the oil level full to avoid any potential problems for that expensive turbo. And don't forget the oil filter. As I showed you back in episode 90 of The Trainer, not all filters are created equal. It makes no sense to use a good quality motor oil and not use a good quality filter. Another cause of inadequate lubrication is the presence of coking in the oil supply tube leading to the turbo. Coking is the solid residue created when oil undergoes severe oxidative and thermal breakdown at extreme temperatures. You know, like the ones we said are present in the turbocharger. One way to minimize coking and other conditions that can lead to overheating in the turbo is to allow the engine to run at idle for a few minutes and then letting the turbo cool down prior to shutoff. Now, this is often expressed in the owner's manual, but how many of your customers actually read their owner's manual? This cooling down period is especially critical if the turbo has been exposed to any extended high-speed operation for periods of heavy load. Coking is also the reason you should always replace the oil supply and return lines when replacing a failed turbo. And when replacing a turbocharger, don't forget to pre-fill the turbo with clean, fresh oil, spinning the shaft through several times to ensure it's nice and slippery prior to installation and startup. Oil leaks can also be considered a cause of inadequate lubrication. Inspect for the presence of leaks as part of your normal visual inspection procedure and recommend correction if any are found. There are a few other things to keep on your inadequate lubrication checklist. One that's more common than you may think is contamination of the oil supply from coolant as a result of a leaking head gasket. Now, the leak may not be enough to cause a drivability issue or set a DTC, but it is enough to affect the longevity of the turbo. Right along the same veins is the presence of raw fuel in the oil, possibly from a leaking injector or intermittent misfire issue. And third, and also common, is inadequate lubrication caused by restrictions to oil flow that result from the improper use of sealants when servicing the turbo or its related components. The charge air cooler or intercooler can also be a collection spot for debris resulting from age, normal wear or tear, or bits and pieces of the old turbo. These are contaminants that, if left behind, will eventually find their way back into the engine and eventually the engine's oil supply. It's also why most manufacturers recommend replacing the intercooler whenever replacing a failed turbo. Now, as I mentioned in an earlier part of the video, turbos work in a very harsh environment, and they generate plenty of heat all on their own, heat that has to be dissipated to avoid premature failure, especially for the impeller shaft and bearing assembly. Now, many models rely just on oil cooling, but more and more OEMs are also incorporating liquid cooling, that is, tying it into the engine's cooling system to help alleviate that heat load. So next on the list of very common causes for premature failure, you guessed it, it's lack of cooling system maintenance. In fact, if the cooling system gets low, we know that that can introduce air into the system, and we all understand how bad that is for the engine. Think how much worse that is for that poor little turbo. And coolant that is overdue for service can become highly acidic, leading to corrosion concerns that can impact all the components that the coolant is charged with protecting. When servicing the cooling system, be sure to use the coolant that is specified for that vehicle application. Also remember that water is half the formula when it comes to that coolant mix. Use a premix to avoid any issues over water quality. And yet another common cause of premature failure is the introduction of dirt or debris into the system via the intake track. Now, that's a little more than just making sure that the air filter is clean. It's making sure that there is no way for any unfiltered air to enter the system anywhere along the lines. So this means we need to do a thorough visual inspection from start to finish. Begin by checking the integrity of the filter box seal and the air filter's seal in the air box. Then follow the intake air flow, inspecting for any visual signs of damage to the lines, as well as the presence of loose or missing clamps. A great way to inspect for leaks in the air passage is by using a high-pressure smoke machine to fill the lines. Always verify the integrity of the charge air pathway as part of your turbo replacement procedure and correct any issues you find. Next on the list is the mention of a few other factors that can lead to premature failure. One is improper carbon cleaning, especially on those vehicles that are having that service performed fairly often. You know, if we leave any hunks of carbon behind where they can find their way into the exhaust stream, they're also going to find their way into the turbo, and that's not a good thing. The second thing to be aware of is the presence of aftermarket tuners. If your customer is putting in an aftermarket tuner or has modified the software and the turbo's operation, well, the turbo wasn't designed for that, and most manufacturers guard against it. Like every other system on the vehicle today, the turbocharger is a highly engineered and complex component, but it will last a long time if it's taken care of. Help your customer do just that. First, educate them on the nuances of owning a turbo-equipped vehicle and the need for routine maintenance. And second, when you're performing the visual inspection on their vehicle, be aware of those things that could cause premature failure and correct them before they have a chance to do any harm. Thanks for watching.